Hello there, ladies and gentle beans. I'm Gamma, and I've got a bit of a weird question for you. Have you ever wanted to be a star? Now, I'm not talking about like a celebrity or a film star or anything like that, with the red carpets and the flashing cameras and the awards and the occasional inevitable mishaps on Twitter. No, I'm talking about a star, a sun, a giant ball of gas that floats somewhere in the middle of space, illuminating planets as they constantly revolve around your gravitational pull. That kind of a star. Now that, if that's the case, then Solar 2 is totally the game for you. And we're going to play it, and we're going to do so by either pressing Enter or Start on a controller to continue. Because Steam is cool like that, and it lets you do both, but screw it, I play with a controller, so woot! Let's dive into this weird thing that I just kind of felt like playing on a whim. In order to make an apple pie from scratch, you must first invent the universe! Ho! That is one wise guy. Welcome to the universe. Holy shit, I am a rock. I'm a fucking rock. But for whatever reason, I seem to be the only rock that is capable of movement. I move around these other rocks and they don't do anything. Am I the only living space rock? Hey, you. Ugh. I can move this rock around. That's always cool. Ugh. Whoa, okay. I have merged with the rock. I am now a slightly bigger space rock. Ken. Whoa! What is this? First things first, a tutorial. Use the left thumbstick to move, like I've been doing. I seem to be a bit more advanced than this space god, as I have already comprehended the idea of movement before he instructed it to me. I've also realized that I can join other space rocks into my divine space rock being, and that is how we evolve in the world of Solar. The universe of Solar, I guess I should say. Puh! Be a part of perfection! There we go. Yeah. I am the... Whoa! What's going on over here? We got a space battle going on over here. They're not going to take too kindly to space rocks. Usually, spaceships blow up space rocks. Some racism there. Inanimate object racism. Press the left trigger to toggle a thing. Planets will lose mass if they collide with things. Oh! I've become a planet. I have consumed so many space rocks that I am now a freaking planet. And if I want to, I can absorb space rocks into my divine planet-like being. So we're gonna do that. Soon, very soon, according to this meter, I will become a life planet. Right now I am a small planet, but once I become a life planet, people will be able to live on me. Move alongside asteroids to bring them into orbit. Press A to absorb the smallest. Press B to absorb them all at once. Or X and square in my case, because I'm playing with a DualShock 4 controller. PlayStation controllers, the PS4 controller anyway, is absolutely wonderful, and it is my controller of choice when I am playing stuff on my Compuninator. That's right. I want to become a planet that can sustain life. Yeah, this is a game that I've had for a while now. I kind of used to play it a bit back in the day, but I never actually did any of the objectives. I'm probably not going to do any of the objectives here. This is probably going to be another one-off video, but I still thought that it would be kind of fun to sort of dick around with, because why not? Here, planet material. Become part of me. Follow me. Set me free. Trust me, and we will escape from space. I guess that would make these moons if they're orbiting me, right? Well, I've got a lot of moons. There we go. Whee! Oh! Ow. Oh god, the rocks are eating the other rocks! We've got space rock cannibalism going on here. Oh! Oh no! We lost one! Ah! Get back! You can't escape my planetness! There we go. He was absorbed by another space rock. Whoa! Come here, you. Ah, gotcha. Harp. Ah! Come. Oh no! We lost that one rock. And then it banged into us. Alright, we've got enough space rocks. We've evolved. We are evolving. Oh Lord, are we ever evolving? As we continue to get more space rocks. And our evolution is complete. We are now a life planet. We have shield technology because we have life living on us, and I guess they've already kind of advanced to the point where they can sustain life. I think that may have been a spaceship of ours that we just kind of killed with that rock that's kind of just swinging around like it's a fucking mace. Or maybe they're neutral ships, who knows. Either way, how is this physically possible? We are a planet. We are an autonomous planet that is not anywhere close to a fucking star. How is anything able to live on us unless, like, the planet has some sort of a, like, atmospheric containment, like, field or something like that? But even then, we would have had to have been part of a star system beforehand in order for that to be a proper thing. Whatever, we're gonna eat these rocks. We are generating ships, and they are destroying space rocks for us, even though we kind of want them because we can transform into a star somehow. I'm pretty sure that's not how it happens. I'm pretty sure that a planet doesn't just turn into a star after a while. I mean, someone can prove me wrong if they really want to, but, you know, doesn't make sense that a giant ball of land somehow turns into a giant ball of incandescent gas. Know what I mean? How does a planet turn into something that hurts your eyes when you, like, look directly at it? This game's got some serious splaining to do. Ow, ow. It's a good thing we've got a shield protecting us, and ships that get rid of the rogue asteroids. when we're not eating them. Come on. Whoop, whoop. Ow. Oh, jeez. We've got, we found a star system! With evil ships. Oh god! They are attackinating us. Hello, my planety friend. You must be dead because you are kind of drifting completely without a star to provide you with any kind of atmosphere. Livable atmosphere, anyway. Hey, hey, evil ship. Taste rock, you stupid alien fuck. This music kind of sounds like Super Nintendo. I don't like that these space rocks can kill our own ships. So is time going incredibly fast? I say that just because these things are orbiting around this planet really quickly, and these spaceships are just kind of coming out of nowhere, so we must be moving either incredibly slow and time is just kind of dilated for our sake, or we are the fastest fucking world in the entire space galaxy verse. We should stop running into things. That would be pretty ideal. Oh, more stuff to assimilate into our very being. Come on. You know you want to be a part of my world. Whoop! Ow. No! We are so close to becoming a star. Wow, that took a dent out of our shield. Jesus. Let's go harass this planet. Huh. Huh. Oh god, we are running low on the ability to live as a planet that can sustain life. Our shield is almost out. Oh my god, those are some fast-moving asteroids. Woo! It's like a space mace, look at that thing. Whoosh, whoosh. We could fuck a world up with these. But we're not going to. What we're going to do is instead is we're going to eat these up. We're going to get a couple more because we only need a couple more and we'll become a star. We'll become a shooting star. Might as well be one at the rate that we move. Ah, yeah! move across a planet to pull it into your orbit. Takes a bit of practice. Press A to absorb the smallest object in your system. And we've got a planet. We've actually got a planet. Now everything makes sense because this planet could just orbit around us and, you know, live. Now let's go and find some other worlds, and we can create our own solar system. And we make fiery noises. Alright. Now this is gonna take a little bit of work. Gotta make all this stuff hover around our planet properly. So that we can feed our new pet world. Press B to absorb all the asteroids in your system. That way you don't accidentally absorb a planet. Unless you really want to, unless you're gonna be that kind of a planet-killing freak. Ow. 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 Got another world! Become part of us! Or... get... killed? That works too... Uh-oh. We have no means of defending ourselves properly, and they're probably pissed off because we kind of were responsible for their world dying. Use left and right bumpers to cycle through your system. In the interface, press Y to absorb the currently selected planet. Or in my case, the triangle button. Yay. Oh god. We've got three worlds now. That is as much as our star system will currently allow. Because we were only a small star. Once we get to medium, we'll be able to absorb more planets. Ow. Ooh, that world's gonna be a life planet soon. We want to prioritize this baby. Oh, yeah! Now we've got a planet. Now! It's evolving. Uh-oh. Oh, God. I'm getting careless all of a sudden. Can we evolve you into a life planet? Ow! Yeah, we'll evolve you into a life planet. And you know what? We'll just nom you. Because you don't have life in you. You're expendable. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that this isn't actually how planets are made. I don't think the planets just go around eating other planets, and then that just makes them into bigger planets that eventually makes them turn into stars. But if that is the case, then damn, that means that cannibalism is actually the way of the universe. Ooh, what planet did I... Ooh. I have two life planets now. You are no longer of any use to me. Goodbye. I wish to expand my starriness. Yes. I have two life-sustaining worlds under my pull. Let us go find more non-living worlds to numb upon. And maybe even a living world, if they are butts. And the best part is you can basically just... Ooh, hey, what's up? The planets are killing their own ships. It's always a good sign, right? Uh-oh. Oh, God. That was completely not wanted. Not running into planets is kind of a good idea. You want to eat them, not put your face into them. That just makes life unfun for everyone. Unfun is now a word, apparently, according to me. As of, like, now-ish ago. Why aren't these things gravitating anymore? I want to evolve, you sons of bitches. There we go. Oh. There we are. Boop. Gotta stop killing those ships. As impossible as that probably sounds. That solar system thinks that it's better than us. It's a fucking red star. Whatever, man. We're just as good as you. Even though I'm just a baby blue star and... Whoa. Hi. What? This must be what it's like to be Unicron. Just going around eating planets. Dude, why were they just shooting at that world? I don't think there was any reason for them to have beef with that pink planet. There's a world. It's green. That means that it must be healthy. Soon, very soon, very, very, very soon, we're going to be moving up in the star world. Oh, look at all these rocks. Look at all those rocks. Oh. Yummy. Come on, one more. Come back, pink world. I want to swap insurance info. Uh-oh. Oh, no, it's fucking veering away. No, oh! Damn it. Oh, God, run away. Oh, God, oh, my God, planets are chasing me. Oh, Jesus. I just lost a shit ton of my evolution. That is not good. Oh, that sucked. I was so close to achieving perfection. It's not fair, man! It's not fair! Oh, shit. Oh, what the crap was that? Shit. Oh, jeez. Sorry, I had to check something real quick. be back in a moment. Okay, I'm back. Just wanted to check real quick to see how long the video has been so far. We're making good time, I'd say. Considering the nature of this video, I'm cool for it going a bit longer. Especially since I want to become a medium-sized star. Dag nabbit. Uh-oh. I think I may have killed one of my life planets. Shit. I think I did. I don't remember this world having nearly as much... well, my star having as much life in it now. Mass. Oh well. Sometimes I guess you need to make sacrifices. Today's sacrifices do make tomorrow's abundance. There's a life planet. There we go. Too bad it's like almost fucking not worth it. Don't blow that world up. Don't blow the world up, thank you. And we are now a yellow star. We are a wonderful yellow star that can hold up to 5 planets in our system. You know, I'm pretty sure that there are actually objectives to follow in this game, but I just like running around as a star, eating up planets, creating new planets, all the fun things that a star does in real life. Hey, look, it's, I stole a planet. I stole this little purple planet. Well... I'm like a great ball of fire. Seriously, I sound like I could be hitting- ooh, I almost did hit a planet. Oh! Hey, another life planet. Oh, and oh, Jesus. That's gonna start happening, is it? Makes sense. Alright, every planet for themselves. Just eat up. Eat up. Eat up all the rocks. Yes. Nom, 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 nom. Just mashing the button. What are we looking at here? Ooh, oh, oh. Nice. Kinda. For the part where... ow. Except for when that happens. That's not so nice. Getting quite the little space armada. That's always something to be kind of proud about. Ow. Oh. Why aren't you getting into orbit? You dumb... space rock, thank you. You know what? Yum. 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 I've almost already gotten up to the red star level. Woohoo! Yeah. Don't get sucked into my sun pole. you guys should really watch out for the sun, okay? If the sun is... common sense, man. If the sun is hurtling towards you, get the fuck out the way, man. Like, seriously, what are these pilots thinking? What, do they think that the sun's gonna fucking just move for them? No, the sun is a giant ball of gas that... I mean, it can move on its own volition, but it's not gonna fucking notice a itty-bitty little spaceship getting in the way of it. No, that's not how any of this works. This seems like something that you would see in that animated Star Trek show. A sun that's going around eating other planets. Actually, I think there was an episode like that with like a gas cloud or something like that. Also, I am a red star now. A red star with shield technology. Now I can up the ante even further and turn into a neutron star if I do so feel inclined. Let's see if we can do that. Absorbing all of the space rock. For we may have to sacrifice a world. Whoa. What are you guys doing, man? Those like nomads? Whoa! Oh shit! It kind of ate up my two cool worlds. Oh well. I've got this, like, half-evolved, almost turning into a star itself world. That was rude. Planets should know better than to do that. Ow. I do like the music in this game. Remember, always mash the B and/or circle button if you wish to eat only asteroids and not accidentally nom up one of your own worlds, because I think I've done that a few times now. Because I'm smart. And in my frustration, I will eat that world, and that world, because they are not cool life planets, and I want to get neutronic, dammit! Maybe that's why the other star systems hate me and are going to actively chase me, because I'm just eating everything up because I want to be perfect. Just eating everything that comes into my path. The hunger is what fills me. The hunger is what sustains me. The hunger is what defines me. die, spaceships. Eat, sun! Can I steal your planet? Nope. Also, I lost my... Oh no, it's still there. I thought it degraded into a regular planet. Oh god, stop doing that, Gamma. Stop having asteroids circle the sun. It's never good for the sun to just... Oh, fuck me. I killed my life planet! Shit! Now I'm just a ball of fire careening through space. That's really what it looks like. It just looks like a giant ball of death hurtling towards, like, an unsuspecting world. Too bad I can't un-eat my planets. Whatever, I found a new one. It's a blue one, too. Ow. Well, there it goes. I wonder what it's like to be on a planet that just gets destroyed by a fucking sun. And again, like, time has got to be dilated here, right? Like we're seeing like a fast-tracked representation of what's actually going on. So this is probably taking place throughout the course of maybe a couple thousand, maybe even million years. So what's it like when the sun just decides to pull the planet towards itself? Just so that it can expand a little bit. Like, what the fuck is that like? The sun's getting bigger. Oh no, no, we're getting closer. By the way, we're gonna turn into vapor soon. The mysteries of the universe, am I right? Ooh, we can almost life planet these bitches. Losing as much mass as we're gaining. Oh, never mind, we got a life star now. A life planet, I should say. Boop. And we've got some evil planets nearby that we are going to try to ignore. That pink world. I must eat it. Or we'll eat the blue world, sure. I guess it goes by, the mass meter. And not necessarily by selection. Because I clearly had the pink world selected and it ate the blue one instead. So peaceful and calming. This is a fun little dicking around game. Oh! Those planets just narrowly avoided being toasted and annihilated all at the same time. Come on. Yay! Eat up my worlds. For soon you too shall be food. All but the life-sustaining worlds shall be nommed. Come on. I gotta at least become a neutron star before this video ends. That is my goal. think that's a realistic goal. We're like well over halfway there. You know, the way that these planets orbit is kind of weird. Or is that just me? Bye, worlds! Oh, we're almost there. We are almost a neutron star! Of course, we have no proper means of defending ours. Whoa! And now we have another ambition to tackle. If we do feel so inclined, we can also become a black hole. Uh-oh. I'm gonna lose my staritude soon. Go away. Thank you. Oh. Screw sustaining life! We are going to destroy the universe! We are going to consume all the worlds! Well, I'm pretty sure I can actually steal stars now. Or not. Or can we? Oh, no! Oh, never mind. Okay, so yeah. As I suspected, stars can't really pull in other stars. That would probably be a bit catastrophic. Or would it be? I mean, solar systems, like in science fiction-y type things, have had multiple stars before, so it's not impossible. Jesus Christ, that planet orbits quickly. Also, as this neutron star, I can only hold less planets. That's a little weird. We are going to make a small solar system, only to give them an unpleasant-as-fuck surprise. They're dead. Ha! They say that a star gathers planets, only to consume them later. No one knows why it does this. Some say that it is a living being, and that it is striving to become the ultimate object of destruction, a black hole. Sometimes it rams into planets stupidly because it doesn't know any better. But when people accuse it of that, it finds their world and devours them. It's like Unicron, only a sun. Boo doo 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 doo. Boo doo 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 doo. Unicron's theme is one of the most badass pieces of soundtrack music ever for like a villain. It is amazeballs. Come to me, my life-giving planet. We're a third of the way there. I think we shall become a black hole and then end this video. With the universe. Whoa! That wasn't a good thing at all. Be careful, Gamma. Be careful, careful, careful. Just swinging these planets around like they're a ball and chain. Oh, and then they fucking die. You worlds shall be punished for your insolence by being nommed! I am the Death Star. To me, my planet, we shall achieve perfection together. And then that will happen. God damn it. At this rate, I may never. Oh, never mind. I might just do the thing that I want to do. Not with that red star there, though. Oh, Jesus. Hello there, life-giving planet. You are part of a star system now. A star system like no other. One that eats what revolves around it. Rawr! Oh, we're so close now. Because, you know, life planets are rich in mass. No, you stole my planet. I guess you can't assimilate other stars if you're already a neutron star. Maybe you can assimilate the stars when you are a red gas giant, like a red giant thing. Oh well, that won't matter anytime soon. Because we are almost there. We have almost become a black hole. One more. Please be a life-giving world. You'll work.
Ah!
Ah! The only thing that can defeat a black hole is an even bigger black hole. Black holes. Labor. Blah, blah, blah. Black holes larger than you will be notified with red arrows. Alright. So yeah. I'm a black hole. All I can do now is just destroy everything. Ha 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 ha! Oh geez, we are running into evil. Wow, I slingshotted those fuckers. Into me!
Oh no!
Yes! Yes! The big crunch will happen soon. Take that, world without a sun. I don't think black holes move this. I don't think black holes move. I just ate that black hole. Wow, that star system is just getting fucking batted around. Oh, jeez. And that star became a black hole real quick. Yes. Yes, look at all of the life ending. being sent into a singularity. Oh, those planets just got completely fucked! Hells yeah. We're throwing the entire universe off balance. Stars are just being flung around all just willy-nilly. Come on. The big crunch. The big crunch, and then we'll be done here. Oh! Always good to suck up another black hole. Look at all of that stuff just going away. Man, we're messing this universe up. Come back. I just want to be your friend. You cannot escape me. You either. Yes. You will all die this day. Come back here, my black hole friend. I want to exchange stories about eating planets. Here's my story. In addition to planets, I also ate you. Hey, you can't escape me. Fuck you. Hop. Just slingshotting planets around. Maybe they'll hit some other unsuspecting Oh! No! I lost all of my mass. Shit. I gotta do it all over again. Oh well, no biggie. Just stay away from the reds. And they're all dead. I defeated that black hole. I can take you. There we are. Oh, a star system that is mine! No! Oh, I guess it's mine by extension. They ate it, but then I ate them. Come back here. Thank you. You. So all of a sudden, black holes are just fighting each other. This is also something that actually happens in the real universe, right? Someone confirm this for me, that this is all stuff that can actually happen. Black holes can just move around and eat other black holes and... shit. This is some pretty calming music, considering that the universe is being destroyed. Just saying. Like, creation is ending. A giant black void is consuming stars and life-sustaining worlds. Meanwhile, this nice, calm, and tranquil music that fit well when we were a budding asteroid. Speaking of which, we've almost reached critical mass. We're almost there. Oh! Oh shit! Oh shit! Well, there we go. We ended the universe. Only for it to begin anew once more. And now I guess we have objectives. But you know what? I fulfilled my objective. Ending the universe and starting a new one. So, I think we're done here. This has been Solar 2. I have been Gamma, DX27. And, that's pretty much it. I hope that your universe, which is probably the same one that I live in, does not get swallowed up by a black hole in the near future, or even in the distant future. But until then, I guess we can always just be happy that in real life, space rocks can't do this shit. Like, seriously, what the hell? So yeah, until next time, take care, everyone.